Hello, Cinema Satsang viewers, how are you doing? Today we are going to talk about the Cannes Film Festival. The 72nd edition of the Cannes Film Festival is around the corner, so we thought we should talk a little bit about the greatest film festival in the world for cinema, the Mecca of cinema, the Mecca for filmmakers, where the greatest films are screened, the greatest auteurs discovered, where the masters screen their films. Yes, Cannes is the Mecca of filmmaking. It's the Medina of filmmaking. And what Oscars is to the English films, Cannes is for world cinema. And not just world cinema, it includes English films as well. So I would rate Cannes as a notch higher than the Oscars, along with the two other great festivals, Venice and Berlin. Yes, of course, Cannes also has its share of glamour and you get the most media attention in the world. But that doesn't stop Cannes from screening the best films and getting the best films from auteurs all over the world. Some of the sections in the Cannes Film Festival are films in competition. Yes, that's the main section, and only 18 or 19 films are selected from all over the world in this section. Only 18 or 19 films, mind you, the best of the best. So if you are an already established filmmaker, a great filmmaker, a master filmmaker, or you have made a mind-blowing film, then only you have a chance to get in the competition section. So people say, some stupid people say, I'm making a film for Cannes. Cannes mein tera chacha baitha hai kya? And you know, so it's almost impossible unless you make a fantastic great film, or if you are a great filmmaker, to get into the competition section. Mind you, there are other certain sections in Cannes as well, like the Uncertain Regard, where some of recent Indian films have been screened, like Udaan, Masaan and Titli. But apart from that, in the competition section, hardly any film has made it over the past 70 years. Initially in the Nicha Nagar, the first film to win a prize at Cannes was Nicha Nagar by Chetan Anand, way back I think in 1940s. And then Satyajit Ray's Pother Panchali won the best human document. But apart from that, there has been a dismal display of Indian films at Cannes. Some of Minal Sen's films have been screened, one Shyam Benegal film has been screened, and Piravi Shahji Karun's film has been screened or awarded. So because you know, most of the Indians, we feel we treat film as a commodity, you know, hamare liye wo sabun aur tel ki tarah hai ki you buy and sell the product. We don't think cinema beyond a commodity factor. So if you want to send your film, if you want your film to be appreciated there, you have to take cinema as an art form as well. Because yeah, of course, money is important, but is that the only thing in life which is worth valuing? And is that the only thing in cinema which is worth valuing? So coming back to Cannes, the competition section, this year also there are some fantastic names in the competition section. Jim Jarmusch, Tarantino, Once Upon a Time is in Hollywood, his film is in the competition section. Terrence Malick, Ken Loach. So these are some of the great filmmakers in the competition section this year. Also, last year I have seen 5 films from the competition section, and each film is a masterpiece. Each film is something to learn from. I had seen Cold War, Shoplifters, The Wild Pear Tree, and Ash is the Purest White. Burning. So 5 films I had seen from the competition section, and it was just mind-blowing. Even I'm looking forward to see Ashgar Faradi's film. There was a Faradi film in the competition section as well. So if you can manage to go to Cannes and catch the films, well done to you. If you can't, at least if you're in Bombay, come to Mami and stand in the queue for a couple of hours to see these films, and it's worth the watch, worth the wait. So this is in Cannes, the main section is the competitive section, and then there are other sections like Uncertain Regard, and where mainly the first or second features of the director is screened, and it has to have some unique story or cultural aspect. Then there is a parallel section which runs, which has which has got sections like International Critics Week and Director's Fortnight section. Vasipur was screened in the Director's Fortnight section. And they are coming back to Indian films at Cannes. There are some films which are screened out of competition, like Sanjay Leela Bhansali's Devdas was screened out of competition in Cannes. So that doesn't mean the film is selected in the official section. Some films are promoted, like this year Sylvester Stallone is going to promote his new film. So that adds to the glamour quotient. Mind you, Cannes is also a glamorous festival. Like Aishwarya Rai was made a jury member, and she was the first Indian jury after a very long time to be present in the jury. Later on, Vidya Balan also has been a part of the jury member, and Nandita Das has been a jury member in one of the sections. So glamour is an integral part of Cannes, but that doesn't stop it, notwithstanding, that doesn't stop it from being the greatest film festival in the world. Another thing, Cannes is not a film festival for short films. Of course, there is a short film section, and hardly 10 or 15 films are selected from thousands and thousands of films from all over the world. So traditionally and conventionally, Cannes is a feature film festival. So some short film makers also tend to say, I'm making a film for Cannes, you know. But so they are like, it's foolish, they're stupid, they don't know anything. And that just 10 or 15 films from all over the world will be selected. When I'm talking about Cannes, let me talk about other short film festivals, not the names, but there are certain festivals which cater to short films. Like Cannes is a big film festival for feature films. For short films also, there are several festivals which are big in the short film circuit. So short filmmakers should try and target those festivals. Also, most of the film festivals in Europe do not charge the short filmmakers for entering their film, because as it is, they understand that it is very difficult to make a film with your own money, and short films are generally made with your own money, independent short filmmaking. They are independent films. So they know that it's difficult, so they don't charge most of the good film festivals. Of course, in America they charge because that's their tradition and culture, and some Indian festivals charge maybe just to make money out of it. So send your films to other Asian film festivals also, like Busan and others. So yeah, Cannes is not traditionally for short films. Also, it has its share of controversies. Cannes Film Festival, for example, Truffaut was banned at Cannes Film Festival for saying something. But next year he came back and his film 400 Blows won the best film at Cannes. Recently, Lars von Trier was banned for his comments on Hitler. Then there was a protest by women, the actresses, the directors, because on the Cannes Film Festival, you are only allowed to walk the red carpet with heels. So women were protesting a few years back this practice at Cannes, that why this discrimination, that we have to wear heels for the red carpet. So all these things make Cannes a very interesting film festival. Of course, it's located in a beautiful place, but the most important thing is the cinema, the grammar of cinema, which we see at Cannes, because they valued not only the story, but also the form, where form and content go hand in hand. And we at Cinema Satsang keep on stressing that cinema is not just story, but the way the story is told. That is also extremely important, extremely, extremely important. So form and content go hand in hand. So every year you will see something new. You will see some new form of filmmaking, some new kind of treatment, where the director is also given a separate prize, the Best Director prize. Last year, Cold won, Pavel Pavlovsky won that award, and the best film went to Shoplifters, which was a remarkable study in Japanese society. So let us follow the Cannes Film Festival, which starts from 14th May on its official website or its YouTube channel, and enjoy some great interviews of filmmakers and the cast and crew. And let's wait for all the films to come, some of the films at least, at Mami. And yes, our Indian delegations are also going. Aishwarya Rai, maybe, Sonam Kapoor, Kangana, Deepika, they are all going to sell soaps and shampoos and endorse their brand. और बाकी दुनिया फिल्म बना रही है, फिल्म देख रही है, और हम क्या पहनना है रेड कारपेट पे और कौन सा शैम्पू या तेल बेचना है इसके बारे में ये भी फॉलो, यही पेपर में भी यही आएगा कि आज दीपिका दीपिका वोर दिस ड्रेस एंड शी सोल्ड दिस शैम्पू. आई डोंट थिंक एनी गुड कवरेज विल बी देयर ऑफ द फेस्टिवल अपार्ट फ्रॉम हु इज सेलिंग व्हाट. सो या please share the videos if you like them, otherwise we'll be disheartened, discouraged, and hope Cinema Satsang continues. And so please share and like, and you are appreciating, that's so wonderful of you. Because of your appreciation we are going on, but also share and increase the viewership. Thank you, God bless you from Cinema Satsang.